Hey everybody, this is Devin Millar. So the Unite team has finally finished their project for Payback. So without further ado, this is my review on Payback Unite. Here is what they changed. So to start with, the graphics are slightly different. The sun is way more brighter and more intense. The shadows and lights are fully dynamic now, and the graphics overall look more realistic. I'm assuming they were trying to base this off of the trailers and demos for the game back in 2017. There's now clouds in the sky, and at night there's stars and a moon, and it looks more cartoony. The dealership has an orange bloom to it, and the garage has a bright white light and it looks more like a car show. Sort of similar to the way that Heat Unite's garage look. Also, the tire smoke when you do burnouts or drift is bigger and way more overwhelming, also like Heat Unite. Interface-wise, there is a much more futuristic-looking speedometer. Your mini-map character is now blue, and there's a compass-like interface with the mini-map. Another major change is the performance shop. You can now upgrade your car simply by buying all the parts. All you need now is money, and you no longer need to do trade-ins or obtain any speed cards. Ketchup packs now function as build changers. You can also teleport to any section of the map, and you can now enter any event in the current car and character that you're driving, warts and all. Gameplay and AI-wise, the police and the story and the racer AI are all exactly the same as the vanilla. Some of the car engines have their real sound instead of their classic nostalgic Need for Speed sounds. If you have the handling overall activated, this will make the drifting more slidey. It'll take some time to get used to, but it's an optional thing that's included in this mod pack. Sadly though, unlike Heat Unite and Payback Debug / Payback Plus, breakable car parts are not a thing here. So in conclusion, I think the team have made a really good start. This mod pack is far from perfect and could use some work, but some of the major issues from the original game have been, for the most part, fixed. But if you're a fan of the game, you can probably overlook some of the flaws that it has and sit back and enjoy the ride. So in summary, I will give this a 6 out of 10. Once again, this is Devin Millar, and I'll talk to you all later.